Bucks says he shits himself. Well, you got a deal.
Hey, Trent.
Lick me, baby.
Good to see you, son.
I love you.
Josephine.
I understand, son. This can't be easy for you. And now you're in that room with all those poor folks.
I killed those people's loved ones, son. I never denied it. You ever wonder why?
Because I fucking love you. Best sex I ever had.
Choke on your popcorn, assholes!
It's the thought of murdering your deserving motherfuckers with my dick guard, you see?
Yeah, he's got a big ass dick.
I wish I might. You need to finish it for me, Trent?
Cleanse all these filthy, dirty fucking assholes!
Finish my work!
I know you feel it.
Avenge my death!
Wow, this is engaging. I mean, that was so Viking. Avenge my death? It's amazing.
Any last words, Modine?
Seriously? I just wonder about how Rose unclean, how about my son and Trent, pick up where I left off, and
it was in his blood. I mean, it was pretty
happy. Pretty intense. I had a poop.
I'm sorry.
I gotta do it again? I can do it again. Fuck it.
No, it's okay, Vince.
No, hey, you fucked her! Okay, put it out my phone. Fuck it.
You're ready to die.
Sure.
Right, good enough. You're just taking out one of the cogs in the wheel.
Trent completes me.
See?
I don't complete him.
Never Jolene! Pussy! You disgust me.
I hope your double-wide mother croaks in her double-wide trailer. Your mama's so fat, I told the bitch to haul ass that she had to make two trips.
Hey, that worked. Hey, your mama's so fat. No, okay.
Right enough, but
this can't be happening.
Oh, it's getting good. This is good.
I just got off the phone with the governor.
I thought so.
Looks like he's gonna be moving his charity golf outing the next month.
Yeah, he thought you'd like to know that.
What are you feeling? I'm thinking barbecue.
Yeah, I kind of lost my appetite.
I'm gonna go get some weed. I'll see you in a little bit. Sandy, that's it? I haven't finished?
Yep, I got what I wanted. And that's all you're ever good for. And you know what? You're not even good for that. You are useless. You're a loser. Just like that deep-fried daddy of yours. Oh, and see? Finish yourself off. And I get used to that. We're done. And see? You better finish
yourself. Thank you.
Dumb and tried to off yourself, but luckily all you ate was Sandy's estrogen medication, so the worst that could happen is you'll grow some tits on your balls. Why does she have this anyway?
You don't want to know.
Joey. I saw heaven. Is there a bunch of big black dicks?
Ew, no. I said heaven. Anyway, there was this big jolly man in a white suit. And the most beautiful woman I've ever seen.
Oh, you probably fell asleep to this commercial. It's on pause all night.
Hi, and welcome to Moonheart, the greatest town in America. And I should know, because I'm an American sweetheart.
You know, some have called me the king of Mooseheart. A few have even bowed at my feet. It's too much. I'm just happy to be a part of this beautiful community. So come on down to Mooseheart. We have cell towers now.
And indoor plumbing.
Soon. Mooseheart. That's it.
Mooseheart? That shithole town? Better off trying to commit suicide again.
No. Think about it. It's a small town in the middle of nowhere. No one knows me there. I can get a fresh start.
Oh, why can't I come?
Let's move to Mooseheart.
Dude, let's go! Yeah? I'll pack my white trash
clothes. All right. This is gonna be so weird.
It's gonna be cool. I just hope nobody recognizes my name.
Yeah, you know what? We can get new identities when we get out there. I wouldn't worry about it too much. Plus, it seems like people have eased up on you a little bit out here lately anyway. Dick! Well, so much for that. Looks like people ain't going easy on you. Damn it, I really wanted to see the moose.
No, fuck that. Fuck him and fuck my car. You know what? We're gonna hitchhike. It'll be an adventure.
Sweet! We can stop at those rest area bathrooms on the way. Oh, man! We get to see the moose! We get to see the moose!
This is gonna be cool.
Can we take a smoke break, please?
She stopped.
That was like 20 minutes ago.
We got a long way to go, man.
Yeah, I feel like we're making pretty good time. How much do you think we got left?
We're like 2 blocks away from our apartment.
Oh, that's a great.
Oh, here comes someone.
Oh. This way, please! Yes, please!
Really? The old dump? Most drivers know what direction we're going, so they know if they can help us or not. Pretty standard stuff.
Yeah, but we're standing on this side of the road. I think it's pretty obvious which direction we're heading. I don't think people are going to drive by and think we're not hitchhiking and assume that we're speed walking to fucking Bolivia.
It's just protocol, Joe.
Bro, we've been walking for 5 fucking miles, dude. Really? With the thumb? Do you really think the thumb is going to work, dude?
You've been through this, Joey.
No, you're wrong. You want to know how to get picked up? Watch this.
Jump in, boys. Thanks for stopping.
All right. There you go. Howdy. Joey. I lied to the Mexican girl.
You kind souls are always risking a record higher than it's your situation. You're in the
80s.
Nothing?
All right, you pulled this over for a reason, Zach. Let's get this out of the way. Unless you think I got Parkinson's.
No, I think you were offering hand jobs for a ride.
Bingo, dingo.
No, no thanks, Joey.
Why not?
I'm all good. I figured if you were willing to do that for a ride, you were probably pretty desperate.
That's the most good Samaritan. But my smooth hands aren't good enough for your fat, juicy, chunky pot.
Actually, my wife was Miss Golden Coconuts in 2012.
Oh, that's what Jessica Simpson's up to now, huh?
We're
Get yourself under false pretenses.
Well, it seems Joey's repressing his sexuality, you know.
Is that what it is, Dr. Phil? Excuse me a minute. Are you even suggesting for 1 minute that you think that I'm gay?
Dude, that is so gay. What about you, gay? I'm gonna suck that shit so good just to prove to you that I'm not gay. That's how comfortable I am with my sexuality. Come on, whip that shit out.
Hey, Joey! Oh, 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 hey, stop! Get it!
That's it, you boys are out of here!
Zach, please, we really need this ride.
I swallow.
No, you boys are out of control.
I know, and I'm sorry. You know what? I might have a way to calm you down. We calm all of us down. Joey?
Cher? Cher, I only got an ounce.
Do you want to fucking walk?
And if you want to uproot the law here, probably need to know that. If the killer was never caught, the city embraced the old spooky charm of it and turned it into a little tourist trap, except people are coming in much more because it happened so fucking long ago. But now Moose Hart is just, you know, creeping out of town. Out in the morning, don't you? Can you stop that? Pay attention. I'm trying to give you some wisdom here. I'm trying to help you. People in this town are strange, crazy, ludicrous. You don't trust no one. Even if you see them commit a crime, you don't trust no one.
Well, they commit crimes. You just have to see it. Sometimes, it hides in the dark. You have to ask yourself, are you brave enough? Are you brave enough to go into the dark?
You're talking about assholes.
What we got here? Uh-oh. A couple of shitty white boys. They must be up to no good.
Okay. We might get raped in here. Deliverance style.
Really? That'd be so hot.
You boys lost?
No, we're in Moose Hart, right?
Exactly. Nobody comes to Moose Hart on purpose, so I think you must. Can I get
you, boys? Straight. Keep them coming.
Fuck, are we?
Relax.
Is we packed enough?
Oh, yeah, we're fine. We got our clothes. What else do we need?
Clothes? All I packed was weed and weed accessories, dude. Of course. How are we looking?
Not great. There are no apartments to rent. But this one guy's looking for a couple of roommates. At least the whiskey's good. People here seem really nice.
Yeah, okay, nice. But her other job's a stripper, and she blows the security guard because her dad never hugged her enough because she's a whore.
Okay, all right.
I'm gonna go play a video game.
You do that.
I'll be right back.
Good luck, Jeff.
You want anything else, Anthony?
Oh, no, this is great. Actually, here you go. Just keep your shoes.
Is that how you treat everyone who comes through town?
As a matter of fact, it is, you know.
That's not why we don't get too many folks to stay.
Look, we're just minding our own business, okay?
Mm-hmm. What kind of business is that? Why your friend moving all funny? What you hiding up in there?
Up where, Ossifer?
In the back there, boy.
Oh, just some school books.
You're a school boy?
Yeah.
You don't look like a school boy. Let me, it's not going to be anything in here that's going to hurt me, is it?
Mm-mm. Well, it depends on how much you smoke, I guess. This is a chef. That's,
You bringing drugs into my tail, my precious Musa?
I bet she's hiding more in his ass.
You think so?
Let me check.
No,
it's okay. She can check.
No.
Oh,
no,
okay.
Because you know why? I want to know what your business is in Moose Heart.
We were just thinking about moving here.
We want to move here.
Nice people.
I mean, damn! You're welcome to Moose Heart!
Damn,
damn! That's what you had to say!
Yeah, I'm going to have to confiscate this to teach you boys a lesson.
Oh, yes, of course.
And,
wish on your merry way.
Thank you.
Y'all going to get up out of here?
Yes, we are.
Get on out of here.
All right.
Get your bag, baby.
Yeah. Get your bag. Get on. Get your punk ass out of here.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Get your punk ass out of here. Crazy white boy.
No drugs in this
one. It's convincing, but I almost believed it myself. Let's go smoke things, sir. Come on.
Wow. This looks like a nice place to get raped. So there's dead bodies buried in the back. I have an open mind, man. This is the only spot that's available. Should I just stay home? What's your problem?
The cops took my weed, man.
Focus, Joey. Focus.
You Boy Scouts get older every year. You're not interested.
Sir, we're not Boy Scouts. We're here about the place.
What place?
This place. The ad you had for roommates.
Oh, yeah! Come on in. You Jews.
You say that like that's a bad thing, so no, we are not of Jewish persuasion.
Yeah, come on in. You boys, Jews.
Great, an anti-Semite. Well, this part isn't so bad. What's your name, friend?
Hey, I'm Lloyd.
You smell like a Lloyd.
What?
So, can you show us the rooms, please?
Yeah, right in here. Ta-da!
Oh, dibs! You got kids, Lloyd?
Yeah.
Are those infants?
You know, let me show you your room, all right? Because I don't hear you're going to love this. Yeah. There you go.
So where do you sleep, Lloyd?
Yeah, I'm a couch sleeper. Downstairs.
Well, I think you got yourself a couple of roommates.
Cool. Sure, you boys ain't queer or Jews, so... Welcome aboard! You ain't gay, are you?
Me? Oh, God, no. I love pussy. Love women. You know, whip out your wiener, stick it in there, swirl it around. Good times, huh?
You boys ain't tweakers, are you?
Oh, God, no. This is all natural, man. Drugs are awful. We don't do that shit at all.
No,
eating pussy? Eating pussy, not doing drugs.
Good. Well, if you boys don't need anything else, I'm going to go back down and watch my stories, huh?
Okay.
Oh, I don't mind the doorknob being gone. It's a precautionary measure.
No problem. Can't imagine any time where I'd ever need to feel safe and secure.
He smells bad.
Hi, kid.
Hey, I thought you were against drug use, Lloyd.
Damn, can't stand drug use. It's God's herb. Weed ain't drugs.
I think we're gonna get along just fine. Hey, where can I get some of this shit around here?
Go see Patch. Patch is the hookup. Yeah. He'll be open tomorrow morning. If you go to his garage, go around the back. Tell him I sent you.
Patch. Think I can get a little till then?
I'm a kind of a bogart.
I see. I thought I would hate it here. I like Moose Heart.
It's not bad. Where else can you get a pumpkin and a lube job? One-stop shopping.
Oh, awesome. Dude, let's go find this weirdo.
Hey, absolutely. I'm gonna pick out a pumpkin. So why don't you go do your meat thing and inspect it?
Why don't you pick out a pumpkin? Because that's extremely gay of you, but I still love you.
Hey, seriously, we got stuff to do, so.
Got you.
Sorry, are you okay, or?
Yeah, I'm sure you get this a lot, but aren't you the girl from that infomercial?
I am, yeah, and I get that number. I actually don't think they had enough money to air it on the channel, so.
Oh, well, you were great.
Oh.
Really
thank you.
Convincing.
Thanks, I did it as a favor for my boyfriend, so.
What?
You okay?
Looking for Patch?
I'm Patch.
Love the name, man. Clever stuff. You own a pumpkin patch, sort of, and your name... Oh, shit. I see.
What do you need?
I got a
carved pumpkins, tune-up, trunk lighter.
Word around town is you're the guy to see about a green pumpkin. Doot-doot-doot. Huh?
We got orange pumpkins and some yellows.
Weed. Do you have any weed?
I don't usually sell, personally. Are you a cop?
I look like a cop?
No, you look like the sixth member of the Backstreet Boys. And everybody knows that an undercover cop don't look like an undercover cop. That's the point.
Okay, all right, look, want me to prove it to you that I'm not a cop or I'm wearing a wire? I'll get
right naked. Not necessary. Got a lot of spirit, kid.
Yeah.
Want to work?
I'm flattered, but I don't do the male prostitution thing anymore. Been there, done that. When you suck dick...
Hey! Do you want to sell? He who has the weed has the power. Especially in this town. And I run Moose Heart.
Not afraid of the cops or anything, huh?
Once in a while it gets hectic.
All right. Okay. I see what you're saying, Mr. Patch. Fuck it. Yeah, I'll sell your drugs for you. Can I get a sample or something? I'm jonesing. It's been a while.
Hang on.
All right. I'm not going to sell weed. Tell him I'm selling weed to smoke it. How could that plant backfire? Oh, shit. He's packing heat.
I really do not think we're going to find another one like this. This is the best one.
I agree.
You know, why don't you curve it with me? I wouldn't feel right just taking it.
Oh. Honestly, I would love nothing more. Trust me. But you mentioned earlier that you had a boyfriend, and that's not really
No. I said that I did the commercial as a favor to my boyfriend at the time, but we broke up, like, a long time ago.
Oh, that's great. It's horrible.
Here. It's my card.
Oh. Suicide counselor.
Yeah.
That's, interesting.
Yeah, do you want to call me tomorrow?
Yes, I will definitely call you tomorrow.
Okay.
Definitely.
Ba-da-boom, ba-da-boom.
Oh, did you spend all our money?
No, I'm selling it.
You got a job?
I'm a go-getter. Who's the dame?
That's her. That's the girl from the infomercial, Madison.
Oh, the one you were talking about. Boo, she's as white trash as it gets. She'd have no problem sealing that deal, buddy. Mm. Hey, look, my first customer. Hey, you want to buy some weed, kid?
Dude, I'm like 15. He's just kidding. He's off his riddle and don't listen.
When I was 13, bro. Don't be a pussy. Subtle. No, what do you mean? Everyone smokes weed. I'll find that kid again. He looked real familiar.
Call 47. Call 47.
Welcome.
Get him, killer.
You know how fast you were going?
Even though I'm sure you've never driven a car like this before, I assure you it does have a speedometer.
Huh?
Yes, I know how fast I was going.
You could have hurt someone.
I could have done a lot of things.
Get out the car, dipshit. Hands on the hood.
Really?
You hiding anything?
When you have as much money as I do and you look the way I do, you don't need to hide anything, sweetheart.
Oh. as if you don't think I will search everything.
Go anywhere you like.
Now spread them.
Oh, jeez.
Uh-huh. Don't you hide me yet.
Oh, no.
Oh, you got it all tight. I'm a gentleman.
You know who this is, right?
Yeah. Some snotty scumbag who's got drug paraphernalia in his ass.
He ain't got none in his ass. Oh,
Well, looks like you caught me. Take me in, officer.
Oh, my pleasure.
Knock it off, Tarso. Do you recognize his name?
Colonel Price, so what?
It's the mayor's son.
Well, you know my name, and I don't have the pleasure of knowing yours. I'm sure my father would love to know who's harassing me. Let me guess. The Jeffersons.
That is funny.
Let's see what we got. We got Johnson and Thompson. Now that I got that, I own you. How about you get that door for me, all right? Thank you so much. Now get your hands off the car. Thank you.
It's a pretty color.
Yeah.
Let me help you with the seatbelt,
Don't touch the car. Yeah. You guys have a great afternoon.
Okay.
Good education. Solid job history. And this Mr. Lloyd Paxson can vouch for you?
That's what I pay him for.
Well played. Well played. That's what I pay him for. That's good. Yeah. Well, I see no reason why you can't join the team today.
Really? Well, that's great. Thank you.
I won't be hiring you, though.
But you said...
I say I'm running for mayor of Mooseheart, kid. And this is not the time for me to bring outsiders in. I mean, as far as I know, you could be one of Mayor Price's spies.
No, I'm no spy.
Yeah?
Please, Mr. Pilton, Your Highness, Your Honor, Judge Pillington,
good.
This is the best place hiring in town right now. Mm. And the economy around here really isn't that great.
I know. That's why I'm running for office, kid. Come on, pay attention, Troy. Pay attention. Nobody's going to hire you if you don't pay attention. All right, go see Rosa in unemployment. Now, go.
Thank you for your time. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Pass some of these out to your friends. Yeah. Give some to Rosa, too. All right?
Sure.
Go.
Yeah.
He said all that? That's just crazy. He's no real chance to be a mayor. Vote for me and get free bail? You gotta be kidding me. He's been a terrible judge. Pissed off a lot of people around here, handing out bogus sentences for no reason. He's a shady and corrupt man.
Shady and corrupt? That would never work for a politician. So, where is everybody? I would think this place would be packed.
Oh, it would be, if we could help them. I mean, even you, sweetie. I don't think there's much here for a sociology major. At least, not for the money you're looking for. All I've left are HR jobs, entry level. Some farm work, school admin, grief and suicide counselor.
Suicide counselor?
Yeah, but it's part-time. The pay is...
Sounds good. And the suicide rates around here?
Oh, sky high. But just adds to our Mooseheart charm. Haunted city and all.
High suicide rates is very charming.
Here we go. Okay.
Wow. Listen, I want you to listen to something. What is that? What is that noise? Well, there is no noise. My goodness, are we at a library? Are we at a hospital? Are we in a museum? I don't know. Are we at a morgue? No. We are at the Mooseheart Unemployment Office. But there is nobody here. Because I am the mayor that leads with 100% efficiency. Damn it. Well, every now and then, even your wonderful mayor will make a mistake. And so we have one person. That's not bad, right? Just one? Okay, I don't even want one. That's right. No unemployed here in Mooseheart. Come over here, son. Come here, please. Son, so you've just had your meeting, and I'm wondering, are you leaving here with a job?
I actually got a number to call for an interview at the Suicide Counseling Center.
I happen to know the man who runs the counseling center. I will call on your behalf, and I can guarantee you've got the job.
That's great. Thank you so much, Mr.
Thank you. So there you have it. I am the active mayor that Mooseheart needs. So, vote Price, because as we all know, the price is right. You turn that fucking camera off my face again, and I will rip you a new asshole. Are you stupid? You're on that fucking short bus, aren't you? You're an idiot, and you're no better either. Don't be looking at him like he's stupid.
Well, not like I was forced into doing the mayor a favor because he has incriminating photos that may or may not be me at a rest stop. It could have been anyone, Pettis! Madison will be done in 10 minutes, and then we do individual sessions. Now, do you have suicide experience?
Oh, I sure do.
Great, let's check on Madison.
Okay.
It wasn't my penis.
I think I started stripping after my dad left.
So, Mada, how are things?
It's Adam.
Oh, right.
Not good. My fiance dumped me. She left me for my stepbrother, who, from what I understand, is more well-endowed.
Oh, brutal. Maybe you should kill yourself.
That's what I'm thinking. There's nothing left for me on this earth.
I know that feeling. Although, just when you think there's no one out there for you, that's when you find them.
Really?
Oh, yeah. There's someone out there for everyone. Probably not you. But you never know. But most likely not.
Oh, okay. Well, hope it works okay.
Sir, I'm happy to help. You're gonna be just fine.
Thank you.
Okay, maybe not. Go ahead.
How did you do it? I mean, nobody has ever gotten through to Adam before.
I just told him the truth.
The truth. Mm-hmm. And you prove that it helps.
Yeah. He'll be fine. I think he's on the straight and narrow. No one really says that anymore.
Not really. But you were great. Oh. I mean, Adam, he really deserved a break. So, are we still on?
I'm sorry, can you do that?
Okay, so every year...
Adam! Haven't you learned anything? You're making me look bad!
I wasn't high enough.
You're responsible for these damages. Come out of your pocket. Now clean it up!
Lupe! Cancel my donation to the orphanage fund. All right. Mayor Price is outspending me 10-1. I need to put all the money into my campaign fund.
Okay.
Lupe. I want these Uncle Sam posters put up all over town, every wall, every fence, every telephone pole. I want the town papered. Oh, and get the high school students to do it. We won't have to pay them. It's a good civics lesson.
Wait. No, bring it back. Just have a good ghost story for or something, bro.
It's your friends, man. I gotta impress them. That's a lot of pressure. And public speaking isn't really my thing.
Hey, now bring it over here. That's where I want it.
You know, fuck this. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna leave it right here. Is that feng shui enough for you? Look, just be yourself, all right? Is that feng shui enough for you? Fucking weirdo. All right, I'm gonna go grab a safe pumpkin carving kit and try and think of a story to tell our friends.
Do it up, dog.
Okay, dog. By the way, how's business going?
Dude, I'm fucking killing it. I'm thinking about cutting out the middleman and taking over this whole biatch.
All right, biatch. Break's over. Move this thing back over here in between the chairs.
All right, 8 Mile. I'm gonna let you take care of whatever this is.
I gotta go. See you, Lloyd. Where do you want this?
Between the chairs.
Happy?
Perfect.
Mandala por el día, my God. Cabrones. Y ahí viene el niño. Los mata a todos.
It's all true. All right, he got a whole new crew, selling all over town. Says he's gonna be the new king of the patch, not you. Yeah, he pumpkin your ass. Pumpkin, get it? Pumpkin.
Go home. Get some sleep. We'll kill them all tomorrow. Oh? All of them. Just like before. He who has the weed has the power.
The show, yeah, okay, yeah, okay, whatever you say, all right.
Thinridge.
Oh, Thinridge.
All right, thank you, nurse. Very well done.
Okay, now I don't want to question a doctor, mm-hmm. but are you going to remove the guts?
Oh, yeah, no. All that seeds and all that squishy shit in there what? Always creeps me out, so,
This is the best part!
Great, then it's all you.
Oh, come on.
Knock yourself out.
Come on, look at that seed.
Nice.
Come on, just put your hand in.
Mm-mm.
Put your hand in. Just do it. Come on.
Ew.
It's not that bad, see? Come on. See that?
You're right. It is kind of nice.
Wow. Looks like I got here just in time.
Connor!
Man, you can't just walk in here like you own the joint.
Actually, I can because I do own the joint, man. Maddie, you're lucky you have such a mature boyfriend. I forgive you.
Boyfriend? You mean the boyfriend who up and leaves me, goes to a big city? No, our little arrangement was over when you drove off without even a goodbye text.
Boyfriend?
No.
Look, I want things to go back to normal. I came home to help Dad with this election and then start a political career of my own, and you want me to do that with you by my side, as we agreed. Every good congressman has a hometown sweetheart story. I won't be any different.
She's not a prize or a prop. Connor...
That's Mr. Connor Price. And I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
Mr. Trent Cash. All right, Mr. Trent Cash, you can get the hell out of my house.
Your house? You told me you wouldn't pull this kind of crap. You said you'd help me.
And I will help you. Being engaged to a future congressman will help both of us, remember? I won't ask again. I'm pretty tight with the local police. We wouldn't want an incident, Trent.
I'll call you tomorrow, Trent.
What? Seriously?
It's his home. He'll call the freaking police, so just... I'll be fine.
Bye, Trent.
Lupe, yeah. You weren't at your desk, so I called yourself. I don't care if you're on your way home to your casa. Listen to me. Listen to me. This new flyer and poster is no good, Lupe. It's no good. The price is too high? What does that even mean? What do you mean I don't comprende? I comprende fine. Dumb. No more, you're done. No more. Fucking immigrants. Trick-or-treating, don't you think? Thank you.
Okay. You sick bastard.
Gotta get the doorknob fixed. Oh.
I'm Graham Short. You've been pinching out of my sack, Lloyd?
Oh, this is so bright. Hey, what's with all this candy?
I ain't gonna be that guy caught without candy on Halloween. That's for damn sure.
You hung over?
You have no idea.
Would you guys hold it down? Come on.
What the hell are you watching?
Scouting report.
You really need to find a new place.
ASAP.
Yeah.
Money!
Who the hell is this?
Oh, that's Quincy, my number two.
Quincy?
Yeah, the operation's getting so big, I needed a little bit of muscle. Ooh. Yo, it's 5-0, that is so adorbs. I love being a drug dealer. Take all that shit outside, bro. Shit. Fuck you, Lance. Oh.
Please, come in.
What can we do you for, Ossifer?
There was a murder last night. Judge Pemberton. He is running. He was running for mayor.
Oh, that's terrible. What happened?
Well, he was stabbed 3 times, and the killer came back and stabbed him 77 more times.
Fantastic! Yeah. The killings are back! Yeah. Just like in the 80s. Yeah. The haunted earth may just count what it is.
You seem to be pretty proud of that, Lloyd. You know, they never did catch the killer.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you got something more to tell me, boy.
Me?
No,
what?
Yeah. You two shitbirds move to town, all of a sudden there's a murder. That's gotta be a coincidence, though, right? Mm-hmm. Security footage outside the courthouse got a glimpse of a masked man. Got a baby mask?
Fire mask!
Not you, dickhead.
I don't. Baby mask?
I bet you don't. Listen, you two, don't leave town. Yeah?
Huh. Clean up this piece of shit and call the house. Hey, was that my son, TV?
Yeah, relax. They had anything on you, they'd have frickin' taken you in.
As long as the killer's on the loose, it's only a matter of time until they figure out who I am. And then they're never gonna believe that I'm not the killer. So what's there to do? Catch the killer.
All this to protect your secret identity?
And because there's a fucking killer on the loose, these idiot cops aren't gonna catch him unless he's hiding in someone's ass.
I wonder if that's physically possible. Focus, Jones. Okay, sorry. So, you're telling me you're gonna catch a murderer? Come on.
Sure, why not? I find him, I stop him. Then, I thwart the killer, and I protect my identity. It's a win-win.
It sounds like a lot of work. And these fucking pigs coming around here, undressing me with their eyes. I could tell he wants to be inside me. No condo. Makes me sick. All right, look, dude, this money's burning a hole in my pocket. I'm gonna go buy me a fat drug lord chain so I look like a baller on these streets. Player, Quincy, wait up!
Oh, your hips would look great.
So, how's it going?
Good. You know, I can't decide this one or this one. I can only.
The one with less.
Really?
You know what? What's the best way to pick out a new costume?
Is to do a costume fitting montage where you give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down.
Yes? Yes.
Well, it's your turn.
Okay. Done!
Smells good. All right. Yo, man, tell your friends!
Hey,
how much did you get for that?
$1?
Did that cost me $10? What the fuck?
Oh, dude, look, guys, it's time we take this weed game to the next level.
Yeah, the next level.
Look, I ordered us shirts and hats with logos. I was thinking maybe we got matching shoes. That'd be kind of cute if we all had the same color shoes. Right?
Yeah, matching shoes, you heard that?
What the fuck, you're repeating everything I say. And look, the main thing is we need to step up our internet game, social media. You look like you know your way around a computer. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all that shit, and we can tell people how much shit costs. They don't even have to ask.
That's a great idea. Great idea. How about we put our address there so they know where to find us?
What are you guys celebrating about, you dumb fucking idiots? You really want to advertise where we are, our address? It's like telling the feds, come arrest us. Come take us to jail. I don't want to go back to jail, all right? Oh, my God. I cannot believe fucking Poppy set me up with a bunch of fake pussy-ass gangsters.
Come, Poppy was fucking wrong, all right?
Yeah, we know your shit. I got this one.
So you really don't like the shoe idea?
How'd it go? Yeah, it's good. What I missed. The shoes, right? I like the shoes.
The fuck up. You guys, man, you need to...
No. Let me show you how it's done. Hey, need a date?
Excuse me?
You need some weed?
Are you new around here? I don't recognize you.
Yeah, I just moved here this week with my half-brother, Trent.
Trent Cash?
Oh, yeah, you know, same vagina, different dick. How do you know Trent?
I know everything there is to know about Mr. Trent Cash.
Everything? You even know about his dad?
His dad? Yeah, that's some crazy shit.
No, man. Imagine having the Bridgeport Butcher to be your father. Poor guy. What a bum deal he got.
Yeah, Bridgeport Butcher.
So, I guess if you're friends with Trent, I'll be seeing you around, huh?
Sure.
Sure there's nothing else I can do you for?
No, I think I'm good. You've been really helpful as it is.
Yo, it's too obvious, man. Come on, hurry it up. Get the fuck out of here.
I'll see you around, man.
Come on.
That was cool, man.
Whoa.
Man, I got $50, dude. That guy was rich. Hey, we're all going to Denny's, motherfucker.
Don't worry about it. You'll be fine.
How long does it have to be?
I don't know. Never. No, it's not a big deal.
Really?
Well, actually, we do take it kind of seriously, so if your story sucks, you know, they might possibly kill you. Possibly.
Oh, that's it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
You'll be fine. Please stop worrying, Mr. Cash.
We can get late tonight. We need to start this stuff soon, okay?
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Since I ended it last year, I'm going to start off this year's gathering with a little story I like to call Don't Turn On the Lights. Okay. So, basically...
She just started her story, so I have...
That's awesome. I brought it this year.
Yeah, you brought it, girl. What's up? All right. Okay. I guess, I guess it looks like Trent will be closing this out.
Okay.
You got it, Trent. You got this one, buddy.
Hey, make it quick.
And good.
Okay. All right. For the approval of the Midnight Association, I submit the keyhole.
Ooh.
Stop copying, right? Now, weary business traveler who walks into this place. Again!
Oh,
thank you.
Dude, what the fuck happened to his eye?
I don't know.
All right, all right. Now that we're done with that dog and pony show, I have a story of my own.
Oh, God. Dude, let's just call it a night.
I said I have a story.
Hope it's not boring. I mean, no offense, you're this, like, politician guy now. It's probably not even going to be scary.
Oh, it's frightening indeed. Real scary. Scarier than your pussy little fairy tales you've been telling tonight all put together. Because my story is based in truth. And truth can be very, very chilling.
Ripped from the headlines, I like it.
Ripped from the headlines, indeed. It all starts with a very bad man. A man that's bad and he just can't help it. Something that's inside him. Something that he was born with. Have you ever heard of the Bridgeport Butcher?
Yeah, they killed him.
Yeah.
But he comes back from the dead, right?
Well, not exactly. Let's just say the Bridgeport Butcher lives through his children. His son in particular. His son was born into pure evil. And he's not just lost somewhere in the world. He's right here in Moose Heart.
What?
It's the killing.
Oh, yeah. And he is sitting here among us right at this campfire.
No.
See, sitting right next to my Madison.
Trent?
I knew there was something strange about him.
Take it away, Trent.
Is this true?
No. Sort of. It's really complicated.
What do you mean it's complicated? Yes or no? Are you the son of the Bridgeport Butcher, Trent?
Yeah, but it's not.
Yes. I am out of here.
Trent Modine, son of Vincent Modine, the Bridgeport Butcher, in town just in time for Pilmington's death. Coincidence?
Brenda, maybe you could help me clean up.
I did.
Whiny little slut. Okay, thanks, sis.
Madison, wait.
You should have told me.
This is where I one-up you and get the girl. So you go and do whatever it is that you do alone, okay? Oh, and your story scared the shit out of me.
Thanks.
Hey, don't worry about him. He's kind of a jerk.
Fuck off, Brittany. Sorry.
I understand.
Okay. I'm gonna...
Take care.
Sorry about the mess.
What are you doing here, Trent?
Just wanted to talk.
Why are you covered in eggs?
Eventually, I'll learn how to make an omelet. Anyway, you ran out pretty quick the other night.
Could you blame me?
No, I don't blame you. I would run, too. I did run. It's a moose heart. Look, I am who I am. My father was who he was. It's not fair to judge me on that.
That's what you think I'm doing.
That's what everybody's doing. And that's why I came to Mooseheart. I thought I could get a fresh start. I figured a town with such a morbid history might actually accept me. And I was wrong.
Yeah, you don't get it. You don't get it at all. This has nothing to do with your father's past. This has everything to do with your mind. And you don't lie. Not to me.
Madison.
You know what? I'm done.
This is fun, dude. I feel like a cop or a robber or some shit.
Gotta focus, man.
Okay. Holy shit, Trent, you're joking. This is a real fucking murder scene. Patch really is dead.
I told you, man, I wouldn't make some shit like that up. I saw him wrapping up the scene when I was on my way back to Madison's house. I know these cops missed something. We gotta get in there. We gotta find these clues. Find out who this killer is and clear my name.
Oh, this is spooky.
Man, we're supposed to be looking for clues.
Relax, Sherlock, homo. The cops already came through here. I doubt you're gonna find anything that they missed.
Then why are you here?
To get his weed shit, and from what I remember, dead people don't smoke weed that much. Oh, dude! The cops left all this shit! Bro, what the fuck? No scale? Oh,
killer was wearing shoes. Good. What the fuck are they doing here?
Shit. Joey! Candy corn! I'm good, dude. I haven't smoked yet. No, look! There's candy corn all on the floor. Oh, shit. You think the candy corn killer's behind all these killings?
Either that or it was left here to distract us.
Hmm. Who would want to kill Patch?
There's gotta be a rhyme, a reason, a pattern,
What?
Okay, so the killing started right after we moved to Mooseheart. I didn't do it. Who else came to Mooseheart around the same time?
I don't know.
Connor Price.
Who the fuck?
God, I knew it!
Who's that?
Fucking psycho!
Oh,
it makes sense. Still can't figure out, though, how he knew about me and my dad. I mean, nobody knew about that except us.
And that guy you told.
Joey? What guy?
That was a good-looking dude I sold weed to. He said you told him everything. He has sparkly eyes, an amazing body. He's kind of got a six-pack, and he's got, like, a nice ass. He drives a fancy sports car. He's like a model-looking dude.
You told Connor Price about me? About my dad?
He said he knew everything.
Are you outside of your fucking mind? Joey, what was the main reason that we moved to Mooseheart? So I could put that nonsense behind me. How could you... What, you got a joke? You tell me a fucking joke. You got another fucking joke?
Bro, relax. It doesn't even matter.
Fuck! What did you do? Ruined everything.
You ruined everything! You ruined everything because you wanted to move to this shithole town because you're too much of a pussy to face the music! You're not even my real brother.
Thank God for that.
You better hope you didn't break this nose. This is a fucking Picasso! Piece of shit.
Oh, thank you. Thanks, God, for the applause. Thank you. Thank you. Plenty of room for everybody. There'll be time for pictures and for talking.
This press conference will be brief. My sole intention today is to bring attention to the string of murders that have hit our crooked little town. Thankfully, the police, they do have a key suspect. Now, we can't say the name of this person yet this time, but I will tell you right now. It is Trent Modine. He is the son of the Bridgeport Butcher. He recently moved to Mooseheart. Let me tell you this. They also found candy corn at the scene of the murder. Yes. questions?
I didn't say.
Excellent question. What he asked was, will we still have the Halloween party at City Hall? Well, of course it will. My goodness, the Moose House Halloween bash. Well, it is the stuff of legends. I think we can all say that. Nobody celebrates Halloween like we do. Pictures?
Tootie, take a picture.
You know, some people, they say that our little town is haunted. And that it has been since 1984 and the candy corn murders. Murders, which, by the way, have never been solved. Is it the same person? Well, tune in and find out who's on. I'm out.
Connor's toothpick? I found it at the scene of Gary's murder. Oh, and, Gary's dead. Has Connor been here?
No! Connor, it's Halloween night. He's at his daddy's Halloween bash, handling his work. Wait, I'm sorry, Gary's dead?
Yeah, sorry about that. And, Patch, too, and your friend, Brittany.
Yeah. Wait, who is Patch?
Slimy drug lord that owned that, like, little makeshift pumpkin patch thing on the side of the garage.
Yeah,
he was a really, really nice guy. Anyway, I'm gonna go find Connor, and I'm gonna stop him.
Okay, well, I'm gonna come with you.
No.
Are you seriously gonna play the cliche hero guy right now? Especially dressed in your little tight pants?
Okay, fine. You can come.
I've never done anything fucking like
dude,
that.
You should have brought fucking Spanky with us. What made you think we should expand? Dude, fucking Jesus. Moose Heart's not good enough for you.
Because we didn't need fucking Spanky for this one. You know he doesn't see our vision. And I told you, all right? There. Now that Patch is out of the picture, we need to send a message that we're running this shit. Remember, he who has the weed has the power.
Yes. So we need all the fucking weed.
Okay, yeah, dude. But you could have fucking at least warned me that we're gonna double cross those two motherfuckers.
You know what? You got a bad smoker face. You remember the other night when we were playing poker?
Yes.
You were fucking terrible.
Dude, it's not the same thing.
Why are you being a little bitch, dude? We got the drugs and the money.
Right, dude, you are losing your fucking mind, all right? Fucking, dude, this isn't how we do business.
No, I don't like your tone with you lately. You've been acting like a little...
Oh, shit. Who the fucking cops, dude?
Yeah.
Oh,
shit. Oh, hide that shit.
No.
Put the fucking gun away.
Dude, no way.
I know how this shit goes down, man, and I'm not going back to prison, bro.
In the prison? Oh, we gotta talk more.
It's terrible.
Really?
Okay, tell me something. Is it true what they say in the showers with the other men, or is that just in the movies? I just gotta know.
That shit does not go down.
I'm
not letting that shit happen to me again.
All right, dude, just trust me. Just put this shit away and do as I said. I got this covered. I got it covered.
Ow, ow.
Just get your cell phone out. Trust me. Get your phone out.
Get it on camera mode. Get it on fucking camera mode.
Oh, shit. Cover this shit. Cover the fucking
okay, sir, I'm gonna need you to...
This is completely legal. This is completely legal. That's right. Uh-huh, to begin protecting my weed.
Halloween?
Oh, shit, go to the bash, go to the bash.
Oh, shit.
Okay, it's gonna go, just go straight.
Where is everyone?
Looking like a serial killer in this game. Linda, where's Connor? He's stuck with his dad taking photos. There's a warning that the party sucks.
What
class suit. Who are you supposed to be?
Brittany.
Oh, I like that one.
Cops are here. Arrest him! Connor Price. He's the one that killed those people.
Mr. Mayor, sir. How would you like to handle this?
I want you to arrest them, and I want you to taste them.
Fuck that. Let's go and get him in the car.
That's gotta hurt. Okay, well, look, I'm gonna go to my office. Perhaps you should do the same. We have a lot of work to do, and this party sucks. First off, you're gonna realize. You see all this? This is yours. Okay, and I'm not talking about this shithole moose heart, okay? This United States of America will be yours, Connor, one day. These are important times. You got the... What the hell? This is nothing but crap. Let's do some push-ups, you lazy asshole. Look what I've done to stay together. How about both? Here you go. That chocolate.
How about a sucker? Hey, where's Trent? Nice outfit.
Oh, thank you. Cops got him.
What?
I think he's the candy corn killer.
Oh, shit. We need your help, man.
Yeah, probably not a bad idea to get out of here. I got an idea. Come on. This way.
He's been crazy. Absolutely nuts.
Well, you know, I've seen a lot in my day, and I haven't told you. Go ahead.
I bet you haven't.
Are you okay?
No. I don't like it in there. It hurts bad.
What? Nothing. Don't worry. I got this. Watch.
Really? That's what you got?
Any second now.
Give us a second. Hey, knock it off back there. Officer, you have the wrong person.
Connor Price. He's the murderer. Do the right thing and arrest that douchebag.
Freak show? Pushing a car? What the hell? Oh, I bet he's got some wild stuff in there.
Well, we got room in the back for one more.
All right, let's do it. All right, what's the problem here?
Problem is nothing. No problem here.
Well, you know you got to get the car off the side of the road. It's the law.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. We're going to need to take a look inside your car to ensure our safety.
As well as yours, of course. It's such a bullshit line, but it still works. You some kind of freak?
White people.
Yeah, I'm just stocking up on toys. I'm playing Santa at the mall this year.
Oh, okay. Well, sir, I'm going to have to ask you to spread your legs.
You insist. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, you spread
ready,
huh?
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Little
to the left.
Don't hurt him, Sheila. Don't hurt him.
What the fuck are you doing?
Oh, I'm rescuing my brother and best friend. And his smoking hot girlfriend.
Meow.
Oh, nice work, Trent.
I'm right here, dude. I can hear you.
I know. Take the call. Let's go. Come on, buddy. Now, help me to get these cuffs off. Don't worry. Quincy knows how to sew them on.
Never sewn one before.
But don't worry about it. I still love you, baby.
All right. Stay with me. We gotta get down over this. Fuck, how about this?
Where are we going?
Later's office. The car's stolen.
Welcome. Welcome.
There's not one brain cell among these idiots. Not showing up to my party? Oh, you will pay for that. Oh, but who's going to be good to Daddy now?
That's nice, thank you.
What is the meaning of this? Wait a minute, why aren't you in jail?
Where is he?
Who? You know damn well who.
He has gorgeous eyes, great physique, most likely well endowed.
Connor, where is he? He's sick and he needs to be stopped.
Connor, he is in his own office working hard.
Let's go. You stay here, it can get really dangerous.
I gotta stop taking so many bong hits.
Police are not doing their job.
You're done killing people, man.
What are you babbling about?
Why'd you kill all those people, hot stuff, huh?
Wait, you think I killed all those people? Thank you. Okay, Hardy Boys,
Found it at Gary's place. After you pulled a Michael Myers on him?
Halloween, a real horror movie, finally. You know, you really should stop chewing toothpicks. It's a bad habit, and it's gonna ruin that perfect smile. Just saying.
Yeah, I know, it's a bad habit I picked up from my dad. Oh, shit.
Fuck.
Yeah, that's right. Uh-huh. Yeah, Mayor Price, Mooseheart. Yeah, you guys get here. Yeah, no. Fine. I will see you soon. I better. Okay, SWAT team is on their way here, Madison. Oh, come on, you poor thing. Relax. Madison, relax, please. Come here. It'll all be fine, okay? I take care of problems like this every day. So you know what we're going to do? We're going to relax a little, okay?
Okay.
Just loosen up. Yeah, okay, let's breathe a little, huh? What do you say we breathe, huh? Let's breathe in. Yeah, get that chest out there. Oh, boy. Now breathe out. Oh, yeah. Isn't that nice? Breathe in again. I certainly know why Connor likes you. Oh, boy, you're caring. You're smart. Oh, you have smooth skin. Like Brittany.
You know, I think I got something to do. I knew it was you.
Whoa, you're going to take me on?
Oh, God, bitch.
Oh, God, this is funny. Oh, I'm scary. Oh, please don't hurt me.
Supposed to be Connor's trophy wife.
Mm-hmm.
He needs that. But you can't do that. So that means that I have no use for you. You see, when people get in the way, people die.
Stab that dickhead.
I thought the gays were supposed to be peaceful.
Wait a minute, you know?
Oh, please, of course I know. I was hoping the Madison could turn you, but, well, she's just not hot enough.
No, she's not.
You're totally hot.
Yeah.
Why did you kill all those people? I mean, why Gary? I mean, what was he guilty of besides wearing bad sweaters?
Oh, terrible choice. No, he was going to go to the media and let the people know that I was blackmailing him. I couldn't let that happen, especially during a campaign season.
And what about Prince?
He was running against me for mayor. Hello!
Well, what about Patch?
He who has the lead.
Has the power, I know. Save your breath, you're dying, mayor.
What about that poor Brittany girl? Seriously. You want me to explain that to
her? No. We get that one.
But, Dad, we're Prices. We don't need to murder people to get what we want. Why?
Son,
I did it for Moose Heart. Okay? This town, it thrives on murder mysteries. Okay? It's already boosted the economy.
Oh. Wait. Are you the candy corn killer?
The candy corn killer? Shut up, Big Tits. By the way, before I die, I'd like to cop a few.
Oh.
No, I am not, but I did drop some candy corn just to hear it create some buzz. Oh, Connor.
Yes.
Connor, come here.
Dad, I'm here. I'm here. I'm so sorry.
Oh, my eyes
are closed. I'm so sorry, Dad. I'm here.
Okay.
I'm here.
I don't believe you're sorry, but I want you to know that I am sorry for trying to make it to someone who you weren't.
It's all right, Dad.
Oh, I'm guessing this is the end of my re-election campaign.
It is definitely.
Connor!
Yes, Dad.
Where are you?
I'm here.
Connor, here. This is very important. Don't let the people know that I did it.
Dad, you slaughtered like 3 people. I think, it's too late for that.
No, it would ruin the town. No. A political scandal. The last thing this place needs. No, just tell them that their wonderful mayor, he was one of the killer's victims, okay? And that will legitimize the town as truly scary and haunted
and unsafe.
Dangerous.
Oh, sorry, I was Snapchatting this. Are we doing a bit? This town is too late. Mayor's dead. I tried.
We're not seriously going to just sweep this under the rug.
Yeah.
Why?
He's the hero that Moose Heart needs. Our silent guardian. Our watchful protector.
He ain't doing any of that. He's dead. Oh, Dark Knight. Another movie reference. Not a horror movie, technically, but I get it.
You are my protector and my hero, Trent Modine.
Stupid movie references. I don't even know
the
shh. You got the weed, got the power. I'll meet you at your crib in the now. Got the best green on the block.
Want a sucker?
Oh, thank you, Mr. Mayor. I will get right on that.
And they never will.
Trick or treat, have a happy holiday.